In this Q&A video made in association with Lumino, we're going to answer the question, what light level do you need when emergency lighting is turned on? In a previous video, Gordon and Gary reviewed the 4-mark high bay from Lumino, which has the ability to be easily converted to an emergency fitting. But what level of lighting is required when it goes into emergency mode? Well, the Electrician's Guide to Emergency Lighting, published by the IET, gives requirements for 3 different situations, along with much more detailed information that can be found in the SLL Lighting Guides, as well as the information in the 4th Snags and Solutions Handbook, published by the NIC, EIC and ELEXA, which is actually dedicated to this subject. So these 3 areas are escape route illumination, open area or anti-panic lighting, and high-risk task area lighting. Now, these all relate to escape situations, trying to get people out of buildings. But there are provisions and requirements for when areas remain occupied when normal lighting fails. Usually, these relate to areas where critical processes are taking place, like operating theatres. But the future of emergency lighting may well be stay-put lighting, where the normal use of a space can continue uninterrupted in the event of power failure. The increased efficacy of lighting and the storage capacity of batteries means that we're getting closer to being able to maintain high lighting levels for significant periods of time from battery power. Watch this space to see how that situation develops. So going back to our 3 escape route options and taking them one at a time, for an escape route up to 2 meters wide, the center line of that escape route should be a minimum of 1 lux. Now this is a surprisingly small amount of light, roughly equivalent to the amount of light that you'll find on the ground cast by a full moon on a clear night. Along this same line down the middle of the escape route, the light level must not go above 40 times the lowest value, whatever that may be along the line. If you halve the width of the escape route and centralise it, the light level in this area must not drop below 0.5 lux. Moving on to open area lighting, which is where we're more likely to use the Lumino fitting, the rules change slightly. First of all, we exclude a band 0.5 metres around the edge of the room, then the illumination at floor level must not be below 0.5 lux. And again, we have that ratio that the brightest point on the floor mustn't be over 40 times the dimmest point. Then there's high risk task area lighting. So this is a situation where a higher than normal level of emergency light is required, like where a hazardous activity occurs that has to be made safe or terminated before leaving, or where people passing by may be exposed to the hazard, such as perhaps cooking in a kitchen or moving machinery. In areas that require this, there will be a value of illumination needed under normal conditions, and the emergency level of lighting must be no less than 10% of this. So if 500 lux is required under normal conditions, then 50 lux would be the minimum requirement for emergency conditions. However, the lowest value would never drop below 15 lux, even if 10% of the normal lighting requirement is less than this. So if 100 lux was required under normal conditions, then 10% of this would be 10 lux, which would not be acceptable. It'd have to come up to the 15 lux minimum value. Now, I'm sure you'll agree that the field of emergency lighting is a complex one, but it's also one that it's critical we get right from a safety point of view. Stay tuned for more information in the future, but in the meantime, we want to hear from you. So please leave your thoughts and questions in the comments below. All that remains in this video is to say, thank you very much for watching.